Hi there, this is Ian McKenzie from Tech Confidence. Now today's video, I want to talk about an app which is used to save bookmarks. So traditionally, you use your browser, whatever that might be. It might be Chrome, it might be Safari. And you come up here, if you're on Safari, and you'd add a bookmark. Or if you're on Chrome, you'd come over here to the little star in the address bar, and then you'd save your bookmark, and you can retrieve them in your bookmarks menu. Now there's another way of doing it with an app called raindrop.io. And this is it here. This is a website, raindrop.io. And it works on just about all the devices, but more importantly, all browsers. So you can have a mix and match of Safari, Chrome, Firefox. And if you use the extension, which is available from Raindrop, and I've got the extension here for Safari, and on Chrome, it looks like this, this little cloud, and just get that from the Chrome store, enables you to save your bookmarks as you normally would. So what's so good about raindrop.io? Well, in my day-to-day work, I typically don't use Safari because Safari doesn't have a great collection of extensions, whereas a lot of extensions I use for work, Chrome has. So I use my Chrome browser for work and Safari for personal. But I want to be able to access bookmarks without jumping backwards and forwards between different browsers. So now, because I've got an extension on Safari, which I'm in here now, a raindrop.io extension, I can actually search for whatever I'm after, even if I forget the name of the thing I'm after and I know it's something to do with video, I can type in the term video for search and it comes up with all the different places I can find video. And there's even tags. Now you can't typically tag bookmarks with the standard browsers for Chrome or Safari or Firefox. So even though I got it initially because I wanted to be able to use any browser or device and access the same bookmarks, what I'm finding since I've been using Raindrop is it's just a better bookmark app. It's just easier to use. It's quick. The search feature is what I find I'm using more than anything. But you can simply click here to go to that website. So it'll open a new tab and take us there. What you can also do, if I go back to search, is you can edit that app. Edit the bookmark. So we just click into it and I can change the title of the bookmark. I can change the description of the bookmark. I can add it to a collection, which is just a folder. And I think you have to have the pro version to have nested folders. So in other words, folders within folders. But the free version does quite a lot. And you can also tag, as I mentioned before, every bookmark you have. You can add it to a favorite. And the favorites are usually found right at the bottom of the app. So if I get out of that and come right to the bottom here, you can see the tags are all here. Right, and I've got a few tags as you can see, and there's favorites. I don't use favorites that often. I just use the search box to find whatever I need. So it's a pretty good app. Now, there's different views you can have inside of your bookmarks area. So I can click cards, and it gives you a grid view. Just headlines. I can sort by date or any other way I'd like to. I usually like list. There's one mood board. I don't think I've ever used mood board before. Take it back to list. And yeah, I mean, so that's basically it. And if I wanted to save a bookmark, I'll do this on Chrome. You just come to the app, click it, type in your, if it doesn't already have a description, and we're not really on a web page here, so if I went to Android Help, for instance, and went to save that, I could just put in a tag and save it. If I had a whole group of tabs open, I could just click to save all the tabs at once. So if I click save, that's now bookmarked. Another thing I can do is I can highlight something. So if I just go to an article here, and let's say I like this, I can right click it and I can choose save to highlights. And then I can actually search for those highlights. I haven't done it before on this browser, so I've just allowed that to happen. And that way, that highlight is now saved. If I come back to this web page, it'll actually show the highlighted area. And if I tap up here into Raindrop, it'll bring up the area for the highlighted paragraph, and I can add a tag there, Android, and that's it. So as you can see, it's a really good app, and it's cross-platform agnostic, so you can use it on any platform, Apple, Windows, Microsoft, or you can use Chrome. You can use it on Apple devices, mobile devices, Android mobile devices. It actually comes with an app as well, so you can download an app for Mac or Windows. I'll just type it in here. And here's the app. But I find I don't really use the app because I'm mainly in the browser when I'm on the internet, so I do most of it from there. So anyway, if we go to the website, raindrop.io, and we go to pricing, you can see what you've got for free here, which is just about everything you need. And if you pay for it, I'm in Australia, so it's giving me the Australian dollar value. It tells you here, nested collections, a permanent library, so even if they take the website down, it's still there. Full text search, so it'll even search the entire text of the web page, as well as giving you the bookmark when you search in your app up here and you use the search facility. Automatic backups, and you can actually upload files to it, PDFs and things like that, and images, and you can bookmark those as well. Anyway, thought I'd give you a look at Raindrop. I'm pretty happy with it. I've been using it now for about 6 months, and I think if you go and give it a go, you'll be pretty impressed with it. All right, thanks for watching.